I always want to be better. I always want to be better. Every day I wake up, the whole objective of my life is to be better than what I was yesterday. See, criticism is great, but it has to be constructive. If you're going to straight say, teri maa ki, teri behen ki, I'm like, where is this going to go, buddy? Troller se problem nahi hai, tamiz se to troll karo yaar. और कोई प्रॉब्लम है तो आके बात करो ना. मैं यहाँ रहता हूँ, बांद्रा में हिल रोड पे रहता हूँ. आ जाओ भाई, आई विल टेक यू आउट फॉर कॉफी, आई विल सिट यू डाउन, वी विल हैव अ मील, एंड आई विल जेन्युइनली ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड योर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू.
Hi everyone, welcome to peepingmoon.com. I'm Rashita Sahani and today we have with us Saqib Saleem, who's all set to impress us all in his Vote Select series Crackdown. Hello Saqib, welcome to Peeping Moon.
I hope so I can impress you. I hope so that I can impress you, but yes, we'll try.
Yeah, I think the poster and the teaser that has come out, it has definitely raised the bar a bit. And yeah. Okay. So
the trailer comes out, drops today. So I'm hoping that you continue saying the same thing.
Definitely. And tell me something, how has this transition from films to web been? Because it's been different for every actor out there. How has it been for you?
Outstanding. As I'm really enjoying this space. I feel like I'm having the freedom to play the kind of characters I want to play without the other pressures of it. I just have to concentrate on my job, which is acting. And also because it's a longer format, because if I make a show that's going to every episodes for half an hour, 40 minutes, and there are 8-9 episodes, so you actually making content that's for 4.5 hours, so you get to spend more time with your character and understand your character, and it's great for an actor that you can internalize the character more. So I'm really enjoying acting. I think I've started enjoying acting since more, as in I always used to like acting, but I feel like I started enjoying it more since I shot Rangbaz, because that just opened my mind. I'm like, okay, there is something like this that is there, and now people are expecting good content all the time, and it's time to play some interesting characters and push the envelope and try out things that maybe I was a little scared to do when I was only doing feature films. So yes, it's an exciting space. I get to work with great people, great technicians, great directors, great actors. So I can't complain. I'm really, really, really enjoying this space.
Okay. And what about Crackdown? Because it has like a physical transformation of you. We saw the photo the other day that was put out. And how was the prep like? How was, you know, it being a part of an action-packed show?
The prep was very difficult, to be very honest. I'm a foodie. The biggest problem I have in life is I just can't stop eating. And my mother jokes about this, ki Saqib is always angry. You give Saqib food without even asking if he wants to eat, I'll eat. Like whenever, wherever I go, I just keep eating. So for me to stop doing that and to be this really ripped, chiseled guy, to have that physicality took a lot of doing. I used to practically live in the gym. I used to practically, I used to wake up, go to the gym, come back, eat, sleep, wake up, go do my kickboxing, then come, sleep. If I had any energy left in the evening, I would do some yoga. Because for a show like this, of course, I had to be really buff. I had to have those big shoulders, those abs and stuff. But I also had to be very agile, and because I had to do action, I had to jump from places, I had to kick, I had to punch, so I had to be very flexible. So I had to work on that aspect as well. And I feel like for characters like this, to get the physicality right is extremely important. If I would have been a really lanky guy playing a field agent who's fighting the enemy, who's killing, shooting, fighting 10 other people, and if I would have been just a very frail guy, maybe it wouldn't have worked for the grammar of the show that we are making. So I think to get the physicality right was extremely important, and we worked towards it. And what was the other part of your question? Sorry.
So shooting for an action-packed show. I think, you covered that almost.
I love this genre. I love this whole spy world, this action, this espionage world that you see a lot of shows about this nowadays. And I really enjoy watching shows like this. So when this was offered to me, I'm like, yeah, man, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to be an agent. I'm going to be an undercover secret service agent and try and save the world, try and save the day. So yeah, this genre really, really excites me. And to do it with somebody like Apoorva Lakhia, who's known for his action films. So yeah, I thought I was in good hands. I had a director who knew what he was making. And yeah, we just went about making this show with a lot of love. And a lot of sweat and a lot of blood.
And what about your character, Riaz Pathan? Like, what was your approach like to play him?
So Riaz Pathan, urf RP, is a guy who's fighting his own demons. He's fighting his own past. He's dealing with his nightmares, his issues in the past. But yet the larger mission is to save the day and try and stop all these unnecessary elements in society who are trying to harm our country. So yes, it's a very, very layered character. It's a character who is a hero but doesn't have to behave like a hero. He can fight with 10 guys. He can he's a guy who has to do everything and he has to be the smartest of them all. So to get into and be the smartest of them all and yet have his own insecurities. So I think that was the interesting layer that I had with this character. So we tried to do a lot of readings, a lot of table reads. I went and spent some time with Appu. I did like 20 days of a workshop with this acting person I work with because I really wanted to make him look different than what I've done before. And this is my only intention whenever I'm doing a show or film, that this guy has to be different. I don't know if this guy is good or bad, or if this character, I've got the sore of the character or not, but I have to make it different from what I've done. And that is my conscious effort. Try and express different, maybe react different to things. So I do that. I try and work on it. So it has been an interesting journey and I've had some great actors with me on it. Whether it was Shreya Pilgaonkar, whether it is Rajesh Telang, whether it is Iqbal, whether it is Ankur Bhatia, who's very good in Arya according to me. And Valusha. So I've got this bunch of really interesting actors who really wanted to put their best foot forward. And I always want to be better. I always want to be better. Every day I wake up, the whole objective of my life is to be better than what I was yesterday. And I keep striving for it, whether it is in my acting or whether it is in the human being I want to be. I try and be better. And yes, have I made mistakes? Yes, everybody makes mistakes or choices in terms of films or scripts. But have I learned from them? If yes, then I'm happy. I got to become better every day. That's how I see things.
Okay, that's great. And what about your, being a part of the show that's been directed by Apoorva Lakhia? He has, directed and helmed some of the really acclaimed films of Bollywood as well. So, is he, if I may ask, so is he an actor's director? How was your, kind of chemistry with him?
He's a rock star. He's a rock star. He's one of the coolest guys I've worked with. He knows what he wants. He knows this world better than anybody. This action world, how to make his hero look like a hero. And he creates this action space really well. So I thought I was in great hands. And he's a very non-fussy director with actors. He lets the actor do what he or she wants to do. But yet, if he feels like there is something that could tweak something and make something extra come out, he just come and say it in your ear. Ki sunna, Saqib, just do this. Okay. So he's very open to a lot of improv. He's very open to a lot of improv. Yet, he knows what he wants. So that's great. Yeah, when you're doing stuff like this, that's very great. And I'm like a kid like a kid on that set, right? I love action. I'm like a school kid who's jumping from here to there saying, sir, I can do this. I can do that. So he's great to channelize that energy and put it on the show. So I think he understands that really well.
And I was actually going through your social media account and I saw that even if there's any negativity or any negative comment, you handle it with a lot of positivity and, it seems effortless. What keeps you going? And, even if even in these tough times, there is a lot of negativity out there on social media. How do you manage it?
There is only negativity.
Yeah.
There is only negativity. I think I was talking to somebody earlier as well. दैट क्या हो गया यार, मैं इतना गुस्सा, इतनी हेट लेके कहाँ जाएंगे हम? क्या होगा इस दुनिया का, हमारा क्या होगा अगर हम ऐसे एक दूसरे को गालियां देते रहेंगे और लड़ते रहेंगे, कहाँ जाएंगे यार? और मुझे लगता है ना, कभी कभी तुम्हारी इंटेंशन साफ होनी चाहिए, क्योंकि तुम लोगों की इंटेंशन का कुछ कर नहीं सकते, और लोग हर इंसान को तुम समझा नहीं सकते कि तुम क्या सोचते हो और तुम कैसे सोचते हो. तो इट इज बेटर टू ऑलवेज ऑलवेज ट्राई एंड डू द राइट थिंग यार. दैट्स व्हाट आई ट्राई एंड डू. एंड इफ समबडी इज एंग्री और एंग्स्टी, आई जेन्युइनली समटाइम्स आई वॉन्ट टू लाइक आई द अदर डे आई वाज सिटिंग एंड आई एम लाइक, अरे यार ये जितने सारे ये जो जितने गालियां दे रहे हैं लोग, मैं क्या करता हूँ, लेट्स आई वॉन्ट टू मीट ऑल ऑफ देम and genuinely understand that where that hate comes from. I genuinely want to, like, people do a meet and greet with fans, I want to do a meet and greet with my trollers and be like, dikkat kya hai bhai, kya ho gaya, kya ho gaya, why are we so angry, sit, come, we'll sit, man, we'll have coffee together. See, criticism is great, but it has to be constructive. If you're going to straight say teri maa ki, teri behen ki, I'm like, where is this going to go, buddy? This is not going to go anywhere. You have an issue with anything that is happening. Say it, no? That's what freedom of expression is. Freedom of expression is not abusing the other person or making the other person feel bad. Or demeaning the other person. That is just being inhuman. We've genuinely lost the sensitivity of life. We've become so insensitive as a society that it's not right. Matlab itna gussa na, I sometimes don't get. So hence the other day I'm like, I don't want to be on Twitter. I don't want to wake up to realize the toxicity around me. I feel like, aur mujhe itni galiyan bhi nahi milti yaar. I to don't get trolled at all. But my point is, trolling karni hi kyun hai? Ye itne bade platforms hai, Twitter, Instagram, ये क्या अपना algorithm कुछ ऐसा नहीं बना सकते कि as soon as you abuse somebody, your account is taken down.
Yeah.
How difficult it is. I'm like, क्या होगा यार इससे? I'm saying you are sitting behind a computer screen, you're putting fake picture, you don't even post, maybe that's a bot account or whatever it is. I'm like, if you really genuinely have an issue, come meet me na yaar. And genuinely, this interview when you put out, I want to say to the trollers, troller se problem nahi hai, tamiz se to troll karo yaar. Aur koi problem hai to aake baat karo na. Main yahan rehta hun, Bandra mein Hill Road pe rehta hun. Aa jao bhai, I'll take you out for coffee, I'll sit you down, we'll have a meal, and I'll genuinely try and understand your point of view. But if you start with the abuses, then we are never going to get anywhere. And I feel like, aur ye jo sare bande hain, jitne trollers hain, agar ye real hain, aur ye mujhe life mein mil jaye na, they'll come and click a selfie with me. They will never have, they won't be brave enough to come and say what they say behind a computer screen to my face.
True.
So that's how I see it, yaar. I'm like, bahut ho gaya ye negativity. Mujhe mere 4-5 log chahiye jo mere aaspaas rahe, mujhe khush rakhte, aur mujhe unse validation chahiye. I saw a film the other day called Social Dilemma.
Yeah, I watched it too.
Documentary on Netflix. That just, and it's not like it gave me information that I wasn't aware of, but the extent of it made me feel like a lab rat.
Yeah.
So I'm like, this social media world is anyway fake, na? Ye asli to hai hi nahi log. Jo meri life mein asli log hai, meri behen, meri maa, mere dost, mere papa. Main unse validation seek karni chahiye na mujhe. मेरी वैलिडेशन ये क्यों है कि यार मेरी लास्ट पिक्चर पे यार सिर्फ 15,000 लाइक्स आए यार, वो देखना वरुण धवन को 40,000 लाख लाइक्स मिल गए. ये आई फील लाइक नाउ सोशल मीडिया व्हेन इट वाज डिजाइन टू बिगिन विद, इट वाज मेड टू कनेक्ट पीपल, बट आई थिंक सोशल मीडिया हैज स्टार्टेड क्रिएटिंग एंजाइटी इन पीपल, हैज स्टार्टेड टू अफेक्ट अवर मेंटल हेल्थ अ लॉट. लाइक व्हेन आई वाज वॉचिंग दैट फिल्म एंड दे टोल्ड दे सेड दैट how they designed social media to work and how you sent notifications so that you can come back and see more things and they want to engage you. I'm like, what is happening? They want you to see what you believe in so you feel like the world is like this, but actually there's something else. And it's just so mind-bending. I'm like, what is happening, guys? I just wanted to be happy in life. I just wanted to be connected to my friends and connected to the little fans I have. And just be like, yeah, this is the work I'm doing. Please watch it if you want. That's it. and now it's come to a point where my phone beeps and I start getting anxiety. I'm like, kiska message hai? Arre, isko reply kar do. Oh, what is Instagram saying? Oh, what is Twitter saying? Oh, what is Facebook? Yeah. I'm like, I have 24 hours in a day. 8 hours I sleep. Now 16 hours in a day. Out of which 3 hours, 4 hours every day spent on social media. If I take out those 3-4 hours and do something constructive, maybe I'll learn a life skill. I'll become better. Yeah. And I'm saying these things to you, but I'm struggling every day. I'm also in this vicious cycle. Yeah. I've also now, I'm an actor. I have to be on social media. I have to connect with my fans. But I'm genuinely trying to devise some way that I try and distance myself from social media. That I feel like my primary job is to be an actor.
Yeah.
I should act and not worry about all these things. Not worry about. If I get the love, great. If I don't get it, it doesn't affect me. All these things have started affecting you mentally, which is my problem. I'm like, I've lost the connect with people in real life because I'm always perpetually on my phone, trying to send somebody a message, reply to an email. When we are eating food, when we're eating, we're four friends eating food, the first thing we want to do is click a selfie. We've forgotten that me and you sitting across the table and haven't had a real conversation in I don't know how many months. But all we want is photo kichi. Acha, please tag me when you put it out. We've come to this. Aray, that person doesn't follow me. I followed him. So now I'm going to unfollow him. So see where your mind is going. Imagine where it's going. You're not thinking about how you can make yourself better. That what can you learn in life that will improve your life and the people around you. You're only concerned about Instagram and Twitter. So that bothers me. And as much as I'm saying all this right now, I'm also in this vicious circle. But I'm trying really hard. I'm trying really hard to keep a slight distance from it. But I don't know how successful I'll be. But I'll keep trying. Yeah. That's what I do. I wake up every day and I try.
Okay. And I wish you luck on that.
Thank you.
And what about your journey in Bollywood, Saqib? Because a lot of people have opinions now about the industry, the film industry, how it's been. And you have been a part of it for a really long time now. So according to you, how has your overall experience
been? Now I have to color all this. I joined the industry when I was 21. Now I'm 32. So I've been here for 11 years. I haven't done 50 films, but I've done a few films, a couple of shows, and it's been my personal growth as a person. And I have always been welcomed here. I've always been given love by my peers and my friends and my contemporaries. And I have no reason to complain. Whoever I am, it's because of this industry. So to say, it's a bad place, so nepotism exists, so this happens and that happens and groupism happens. Yeah, that happens everywhere. I come from a family of my dad's into restaurants, right? In Delhi. Okay. If I wanted to open a restaurant, would it not be easy for me to open a restaurant in comparison to a Varun Dhawan, whose dad is a film director?
Yeah.
And but it's up to me how well I run that restaurant.
True.
Correct.
Yeah.
And if the food is not good, people will not come and eat. So I can't blame anybody to be born in somebody's house, man. You can't blame somebody to have taken birth in an actor's house or a director's house. They also have ambitions and life goals. What are you trying to say? That people from within the business should not be acting? And haven't we had enough examples of people who are from the industry and who've made their debuts and their films haven't done well and people have not accepted them and then they have not become actors?
Yeah.
I feel like maybe it's difficult for us to get the first foot on the door, but nobody said it's going to be easy. If it was easy, everybody would do it, right? Like when I was sitting in Delhi, no film director or producer called me and said, Saqib, tu na Bombay aaja, main tujhe star bana dunga. Nobody called me. I felt it here. I thought I had the acting chops or the potential to come here and become an actor. I came with my own belief. And then to turn around and be like, uski wajah se aisa ho gaya, uski wajah se aisa ho gaya. Then, hamara kya hai? What are we doing in life? We are the choices we make and these are the choices I'm making and I'm very happy about them. सो आई एम नॉट हियर टू ब्लेम एनीबॉडी और सेइंग अरे ये होता है वो होता है बट it's a good place man I have got yeah. whatever I've gotten in life is from this place to now to see this place being tarnished by the Indian media the way it's yeah. been happening is heartbreaking yeah I've had great friends I've met people who've become important fixtures or people in my life who I really listen to for advice in life so yeah. I don't think it's a bad place at all it's a great place it's given me dreams matlab because of being an actor I started dreaming more and seeing things and why should I not so I this is yaar I don't know what is happening to us I don't know I think we have come to a point in life where there is just hate filled inside us and of course there are bad or good people in every industry there are people who are mean in every industry yeah. but does that mean that the whole industry is bad
no
It's because of some select few people who. So I feel like we just because मुझे ना कभी कभी अब लगने लग गया है एक तो ना मैं लोगों को ये बताना चाहता हूँ इस इंटरव्यू के थ्रू कि मैं कोई पॉलिटिशियन या कोई न्यूज एनालिसिस नहीं हूँ हर चीज पे मेरा पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू होना जरूरी नहीं है आई एम एन एक्टर मेरा मेन जॉब है एक्ट करना तो जब कोई बोलता है अरे आपने उसके बारे में कुछ नहीं बोला अरे आपने उस पर स्टैंड नहीं लिया अरे आपने क्यों लू यार
Yeah.
मैं पिछड़े कर रहा हूँ ना मैं काम कर रहा हूँ दिस इज माय लाइवलीहुड तो मैं वो करता हूँ ना अगर मुझे पॉलिटिक्स में जाना होगा या कुछ मुझे बनना होगा तो मैं जरूर जाऊंगा अगर मुझे एक्टिविस्ट बनना होगा मैं जरूर जाऊंगा और उसका फ्लिप साइड है कि अगर बोल दो तो बोल देते हैं चले जाओ वापस पाकिस्तान सो हमने क्या करूं यार नहीं बोलूं तो प्रॉब्लम है बोलूं तो प्रॉब्लम है ऑल आई वांट टू डू इज एक्ट मुझे सिर्फ एक्टिंग करनी है यार ये सब बकवास की चीजों में मुझे अपना ध्यान नहीं बटाना है सो इट्स अ डिफिकल्ट स्पेस टू बी इन यार टू 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 कीप योर सैनिटी एट ऑल टाइम्स एंड जस्ट डू द वर्क यू वांट टू डू इट गेट्स डिफिकल्ट समटाइम्स टू सी हाउ पीपल आर बिहेविंग बट दैट्स हाउ इट इज वी विल मेक डू ऑफ इट नाउ
ओके एंड लास्टली व्हाट अबाउट 83 बिकॉज़ आई थिंक फैंस आर रियली एक्साइटेड एंड आई कीप सीइंग कमेंट्स ऑन दैट
I really want that film to come out, yaar.
Yeah.
But it's a bahut pyari picture hai, yaar. Bahut pyari picture hai, yaar. It's one of the best scripts I have read, yaar. It's, oh, yaar. Matlab, it's a dream come true film, yaar. Matlab, I can talk about that film for hours and hours and what it's done to me as a human being and what it's meant to me. So, yeah, man. I just wanted to release. I just want theaters to open. I want people to go see it. And I want to see this film in theaters, yaar, if you ask me. Because it's a film that needs that canvas and that scale.
I know.
So I really hope, these theaters open. We find this vaccine for this virus, and then people can go back to theaters and watch films. The cinemas are going through a huge, massive loss for the last 6 months. And you know, when you talk about the Hindi film industry, we are not only talking about directors and actors. We're talking about the other 20,000 people who work behind the scenes, whether it's the cinema chain, cinema people, the distributors, the exhibitors, the production people, the camera people. It provides livelihood to I don't know how many people, to target all of them because of a couple of people you think are wrong is absolutely wrong. I think when the time is to come forward and help the country, whether it was donating for the PM CARES Fund or the Chief Minister's Fund, the actors always come forward. The industry always comes forward to help.
Yeah.
And suddenly you start just hating on them. It's just weird, yaar. So I feel like ki samajh nahi aata kabhi kabhi na, bahut tricky ho jata hai, yaar. Ki mujhe to sirf acting karni hai, yaar. मुझे तो सिर्फ काम करना है यार मैं तो चाहता हूँ लोग मुझे मेरे काम से जाने यार तो कभी कभी हो जाता है बट ठीक है करते रहेंगे यार इट्स अ स्ट्रगल एवरी डे वी वेक अप एवरी डे लाइक एंड लाइक आई सेड ट्राई एंड बी बेटर एवरी डे
ओके ओके थैंक यू सो मच साकिब फॉर टॉकिंग टू अस